Hey guys, a while ago I did a video on animals as leaders and got a lot of flack from it, from people saying I didn't understand what Tosin and Abasi is bringing to the table. I was misunderstood on the genre he represents and what he is doing with guitar-based music and what he means for current players and the direction of what progressive music is actually becoming based on his lead. I was told he's not a metal player. I was told he's not a metalcore player. I was told he is not influenced by Meshuggah. There's nothing related in his music to Meshuggah. And lastly, I was judging him unfairly based on a very old song that no longer represents what the band is all about. So today a new single drops. So now I get to hear what the savior of progressive music is bringing to the table, and I hope I will have all of my words eaten because I want to see the genre progress. I want to see music progress. I want to see the next great thing unfold before me. I want to be inspired. So here we go. Let's see if this is the thing that makes it happen. Okay, so not Meshuggah related, right? So the song that I had concentrated on before was released when 2010. Meshuggah's Bleed came out in 2008. This song still sounds just like that song. It's another bunch of syncopated triplets. It's another, the styling is still maintaining that groove while having your bass drums mirror all the rhythmic attacks. I would think that if you're going to be divorced from that style now this far into your career, if you do not represent what that song, the old song, was, that now you would have a new format to show me that you're going to be actually progressive, because the song that I concentrate on it before was not. It doesn't indicate what the band is all about. This should, right? I mean, we're what, 11 years since that song that I talked about? And it's the same old shit. Where is the progression? You know what this is? This is not progressive music. This is fucking Taco Bell. This is just the same shit that all you guys love, where it maintains that fucking groove and you get that syncopation, but packaged slightly different, in a slightly different shape, to make you guys think that it's new, when it's not. What's new about it? The synths over the top? The fact that they have some kind of dance routine going on with people that look like they posed on the cover of the Obzen record that the Bleed song is on, that everybody that loves Animals as Leaders also loves? Where is the progression? I would love to see it. Let's see if it happens later in the song. We'll be right back. See, this isn't even, you know, if we're going to talk about the music being Taco Bell, this isn't even like Doritos Locos Meshuga. This is just Meshuga. Like, what sets it apart? What, how is, here's the thing. This band and this player have so much influence right now over the progression of guitar. This record is most likely going to cause thousands of people to pick up guitar for the first time. And they're all going to be saying the same thing, that it's super progressive. He's challenging, you know, the boundaries of what makes progressive music. Please show me that. I want to see that happen too. This is not it though. So I like that progression. I like the use of the melody there, and I like that contrast with the rhythmic based aspects that were happening before. And what I would like to see is that, you know, writing that same pitch for your triplets for the whole time. If you want to tell a compelling story, imagine how much more compelling it could be if you change the notes. What kind of story you could tell if you did that? I know that this melody is a little more successful because there's a contrast there with there not having been really a melody before, but, you know, as accomplished as these players are, I would like to see the diverse palette of musical knowledge on display instead of that genre writing type of shit that they're known for. I don't know, man. So the imagery is captivating, video is cool, the transitions work a lot better. I'll admit that. You know, this is a band that has found more of a sense of how to lock parts together. That being said, there's not too many parts here. If you're going to be a progressive band, I would think you would have more parts to tell a more detailed story. But it's essentially keeping true to a handful of themes and having very little development happen within them. You know, and sticking to like one or two themes per song is totally fine. And in a lot of cases, it'll make you have a much more succinct and successful story to tell if you're able to manipulate the themes throughout to showcase that there is an ebb and flow and that there is a rise and fall and there's a climax and all of those things that make storytelling what it is. But there's not enough mood shaping going on for me to consider this progressive. Definitely not Meshuggah. Not hearing that at all. That's it. Okay. So I'm actually kind of surprised that it ends that way. I don't really feel like there is a natural climax that happened. The song consists of maybe two or three themes that are sandwiched around an expansive melodic development that feels really ethereal. And I like that. I think that part works because of how simple the rest of the stuff is. but I don't feel like a sense of profound artistic expression here. You pretty much just have the typical rhythmic manipulation you get from every band that's been doing this since Meshuggah became popular. And he has his same tonality to him. Tosin Abasi still has the same kind of feeling you get from his music. It's not opening new doors. It's not opening new windows to exploration. I mean, maybe they don't want to do that. Maybe if I missed out on a bunch of their discography where they had really compelling music, and this is, you know, the misstep, you know, that's fine. But I have a feeling that's not the case. And I don't know if I have the time to walk it back by listening to all that shit either, but I don't know. I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed because I wanted you guys to prove me wrong. I wanted this shit to, like, be the next step, you know? The metal world needs it. The music world needs it. The guitar world needs it. And we have the same old shit. It's fucking Taco Bell. It's still Taco Bell. Come on. Let's do better. We can do better. All right. Thanks, guys.